Hey there, welcome everybody. Let's get this turned on. Where is the on button? Hey, oh, there it is. Welcome anybody who's out there. It is Tuesday. Tuesday, October 17th. Oh, it's a good thing I got that date right. If it was wrong, I would have had to start this whole thing all over again. I'm just kidding. So, I know I've been kind of inconsistent about when to do these darn things, and you know, it was Thursday for a while, and then once school started, it went to like Tuesdays, and then for the last few weeks, I've been doing Sundays. I like Sundays. Sundays have been working out. I would have liked to have come on Sunday, but yeah, it was busy. It was a busy day on Sunday. I had a lot going on, so I ended up not coming on Sunday. But here I am. I'm committed to at least once a week, so here we are. we'll see if I can't keep it up with Sundays, but for now, today, this week is going to be Tuesday. Let's go to, here we go. Let's start this up. All right. So you know what? We're going to go with Start Co-op. And last week I did a online game also and create a game. Right here, it was on public, so it should be on private to use that ad code, but last week I had it on public, and two people joined last week, and I just assumed that they joined from my chat, from the YouTube, but they didn't. They just joined randomly, and I had no idea. So you know what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this on public, and find out some way to chat with them. That way, if anybody joins, I can tell them, hey, join, you know, come over on YouTube and watch, and then hopefully they'll stick around. We'll see what happens. Okay, that's my goal, right? My ultimate goal is to have somebody join and for me to tell them, no, I'm on YouTube, and then they can come join me on YouTube. Anyway, that's the plan. So let's start. Okay, and I'll still get the ad code. That way, let me move this mic here. That way, if you would like to join and you're already watching, I'll get you an ad code so you can join me directly. How do I sound out there? I hope it sounds good. I kind of messed a little bit with the mic settings before the stream. Hopefully it worked out. Okay, so I'm going to go to start. I'm going to go to manage party and write copy invite code. I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna go, if you would like to join my game, use the code. There it is. And then I'll try to pin this comment. It's always hard for me to pin a comment. Oh no, right there, pin message. Okay. All right. But if somebody joins randomly, I want them to be able to hear me. So if I go here and I go to manage party, allow other players to winch. Yeah, that's fine. Back. How do I make it to where I want them to be able to hear me while I'm talking? That's my ultimate goal. How do I get there? let me go to wrong button. Where is my cars? Where am I? Didn't I have a car out there somewhere? Was it not in this map, maybe? Oh, I'm in Zimnogorsk. No, am I in Zimnogorsk? Let's go back to the map. Global map. I think I'm in Zimnogorsk, right here. And then, there I am. There's a Tega. Woo! Oh no, the TUZ. That's right. We got this last week, guys. Oh yeah, I remember. We got that the tank. Here it is. Okay. So, now how do I make it to where, let's see here. Oh boy. Okay, so there's select, move to player, rotate, navigate, select marker, skip time. I didn't want to skip the time because I want it to be morning. There we go. Global map, back, close. I want to be able to chat with people who join my game. How do people join my game and hear me talk? How does that happen? Continue. Is it settings? Game. Brightness. This is all the stuff I should be taking care of while I'm not live. But here I am. Okay. That's video. Audio. Okay. HUD. Controls. Controller? Steering wheel? Okay, it's not there. Codecs? Content library? Return to main menu? Whatever. Whatever. It's fine. It's fine. Some people will just join randomly and hopefully it'll be entertaining. Okay, so I want to unlock this up here. This, right? Either this one or one of these. That's a warehouse. It must be this. This turns into a garage, and I want to unlock that as a garage. So here's what I'm going to do. I did a little bit of research and found out that it's in a contract called Vorono, right there. And it's called Key Buildings Restoration, right there. Oh, it's locked behind Complete Geo Search Triangulation. So Geo Search Triangulation. Geo Search. Well, I wasn't planning on this. Right there. No, Geo Search Starting Point. I want Geo Search Triangulation. Right there. And what is that locked behind? That's locked behind Geo Search Starting Point. So Geo Search Starting Point. And where is that? Data received from... it doesn't say where it is. Well, here's what I'm going to do. In order to do that mission, I am going to have to be in the Tega. So let me... Oh, I have a trailer. Well, let's recover. I don't think I can recover. Remove the cargo. Not remove the cargo. I have to detach the trailer first, and then I can recover. Okay. Yeah, so a busy day on Sunday. What did I do on Sunday? I went on a drive. I went on a drive in real life. Okay, it wasn't in a video game drive. It was a real life drive. Let's see here. Let me go to customize. And I want to put on, for the frame add-ons, I want to add on right there. Seismic vibrator. Yes. Oops. No, I want to attach it. Seismic vibrator. There it is. Okay. Now I want to leave the garage and find out where is this. So I want to activate the mission. Tega oil. Geo search starting point, right? Accept. Search and scan starting point. I gotta find the starting point. I bet you it's in the next map, because I don't see it anywhere on here. So just follow this main road. Follow the road. Here we go. Ooh, it's pretty warm up in my room today. Actually, yeah, go this way. Go this way. Keep going. Keep going. I turn the AC on. Hopefully that cools it off a little bit. I can feel the AC kind of blowing on my feet. But the cool air needs to work its way up. I feel like I have a little bit of forehead sweat going on. Okay. So I went on a drive on Sunday. I ended up going towards the city, and in this particular town I was in, they have a cheesecake factory. I'd never been to a cheesecake factory, so I thought, you know, I'll stop in, see what it's like, and it's not that good. It's really pricey. It's really pricey, and it's not that good. We went in, we sat down, and they said, well, would you like some bread? And I was like, why bother even asking? Just bring me the bread. Yes, I want the bread. So they brought out this bread. And it was like these three loaves not loaves, like three kind of small loaves of different kinds of bread. They had like sourdough bread. They had a like a wheat bread and some other bread that I don't know what it was. And they were really good. They were warm. They were good. They came out with butter. And like immediately I was like, oh, we made the right choice. Like, this is a good place. I like this a lot. And then the rest of the meal happened. And it was just like one overpriced thing after another. And it was only mediocre. And I don't know how they got off charging the prices they charged, because it was not good. I got a, it was between a burger and a fried chicken sandwich. And I asked a waiter, what do you want? What would you get? And he recommended the chicken sandwich. So I got the chicken sandwich, and it was okay. I mean, it wasn't terrible, but we have a Dave's Hot Chicken next to where I live, and that's better. Dave's Hot Chicken is a lot better than this place was. So I wasn't very happy with my chicken sandwich. What did we get for an appetizer? We got a, what the heck was it? It was these little balls. It was crab, these fried crab somethings. And it was super expensive. It came with six of them, but it was like, it was pretty expensive. I think it was like $12. And at that price, you figure it would come like with some, you know, some sort of side, you know, like a garnish at least. It just came in like, it just threw six balls in a bowl and gave it out. Like, it didn't come with like, you know, like it could have been like on a bed of lettuce with some, you know, some celery sticks, you know, something nice like that, but it didn't. It just came with just six balls in a bowl. So it was pricey. It was pricey. And I mean, the food was okay. If it was cheaper, I would go again, but it was just too pricey for what it was. So, bottom line, Cheesecake Factory is a no thank you. I'd rather not. All right. Oh, and the cheesecake that we got. the seasonal cheesecake was the pumpkin cheesecake. And I like pumpkin spice lattes. I like seasonal stuff, so I got it. And it wasn't very good either. The pumpkin cheesecake part was okay, but there was this layer of like pecans that was the base layer of it. It was way too thick, way too hard. I thought it was like pecan ice cream when I was trying to cut into it. It was so hard and like hard to cut through. So I thought it was like still frozen. No, it was just like a big chunky chunk of this weird pecan like paste. It was weird. I didn't like it. Did not like it. But you know, sometimes you just gotta go and you gotta try a new restaurant. And that's what I did. And now I know. Cheesecake Factory is not for me. Oh, I want gas. Yes, I want gas. So yeah, Sunday I went on a real drive. I actually got into my car and drove it. Like on a road. It wasn't in the video game world. Right. Yeah, so Sunday was, I wanted to stream on Sunday. My original plan was to stream, but by the time I got back, I wanted to relax, and I wasn't ready for it yet, so I didn't get myself online. That's okay. Oh, you know what I started watching? Oh my god, I started watching that Goosebumps show. The new one on Disney Plus. I think they released five episodes, and then later on this month they're gonna release five more episodes. I'm not all the way through it yet. I've only gotten through episode one, and so far it's okay. It's kind of an interesting little setup they have going on. Like, it seems to me like they're gonna try to encompass a bunch of different of the books into one story. Because the first episode was called Say Cheese and Die, and they find the camera, but way late in the episode, by the way. They find the camera like a half hour or 40 minutes into the episode. Maybe not that late. Maybe it was like 20 minutes into the episode. But an hour long episode, that's too long. So they finally find it, and then that never came to a resolution. They kind of alluded at other things, like there was a mask and So, okay, the triangulation. Yeah, so now I'm in the right map because now it says 0.36 miles. So let's just drive. Let's keep driving. I'm going to follow this road and see if it ever gets to, like, you know, less than 0.10. So it looks like they're trying to do, like, several of the books at once with the Goosebumps. And I'm okay with that. I'll see where it goes. I do hope it's better than Fear Street. I didn't like the Fear Street. To be honest, I didn't get the Fear Street. I watched all of, I think it was four episodes. I watched all of them and I couldn't tell you what it was about. I was confused. Am I going to turn here? Do I want to turn? I think I do. Let's keep an eye on the miles. 2.24, yes. 0.23, seems promising. Oh boy, this is muddy. The Goosebumps. So I love the Goosebumps when I was in fifth and sixth, I think when I was in fourth grade, is the very first time I ever like saw a Goosebumps book, and immediately I loved it. Like the bright, flashy, horrific cover was so good, and they were so imaginative, just the covers alone. By the time I was in sixth grade, I was like, whenever I would get one, I'd read it pretty much that day. I would just sit and just read and read and read until I finished it. I loved them. Oh my God, they just hit something. Goosebumps, what did I did read Say Cheese and Die. I read Welcome to Death House. I read, oh look, it's already going. Can I keep going straight or should I turn? I bet you it's on this road, but just in case it is, I can always just take a U-turn here. So let me go straight and see what happens. Say Cheese and Die, I read that one. I read that one, Piano Lessons Can Be Murder. There's a lot of them I read. 0.06. If you end up joining this chat, let me know Goosebumps that you read, because I want to talk some Goosebumps, but I'm just having a hard time thinking about the books right now. Okay, so I definitely want to take this road and backtrack. So let's do it. Let's backtrack this road. I bet you it's on this road. About the Goosebumps books, like at the end of every chapter was always like a stupid jump scare that had nothing to do with anything. It was always like, you know, I walked into my room and suddenly I feared for my life. And then like it would end the chapter, and then the next chapter it was like, oh, it was just my best friend in a mask who jumped out in front of me. Like, it was like the most anticlimactic next sentence. Oh, here we are. We're here. I knew it was on this road. Oh, I bet you it's on that little bit right there. Back there. Nope, this is it. Nope, we passed it. I bet you it's on this little blip. Probably just back straight up to it. I knew it. Wait, maybe I don't know it, because I'm lost. Where is it? Is it like in these trees? Hello? Maybe it's on this tuft in here. It is. Okay, start it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, so I already forgot. In order to do key building restoration, I have to undo complete geo search triangulation. What did I just do? Did I just do geo search triangulation? Is that what I just did? Search and scan the triangulation point. Is there two points? I gotta do the other one now? Is it done? I can't tell if it's done. No, because it's crossed off like that if it's done. Is there still another triangulation I have to do? This game right now is so confusing. Okay. Geosearch triangulation, except... Oh, there's two of them I have to do. One of them's... They're basically both half a mile away. So... Where is a half a mile from here? How far... the wrong button. How far is this? That is 0.3 miles. Oh, you know what? I bet you it's in this sticky mud right there. Look at that. That's 0.5 miles. I bet you it's right there. I bet you it's in this hellhole. Okay, let's go. So, I'm going to follow this road out. Follow this road out. I wonder if I can take a shortcut here. I'm going to try it. I'm going to try to take that shortcut. That'll be the death of me. Okay, follow this way out. Okay, keep going. Keep on going. Now, where did it go? It's right there. Down this road. Oh, Winnendar's there. Winnendar, were you here for a while or you just joined? Because I was talking a bunch. I don't know how much you heard. Should I be embarrassed? Just kidding. I wasn't talking about anything embarrassing. You just joined. Okay. I brought up Goosebumps. Do you have a favorite Goosebumps book or a Goosebumps book that you remember reading? If not, it's okay. I'm just curious. Oh, no. That's okay. Not everybody read them. It really is an older generation kind of a thing at this point. You know, I was in elementary school back in the 90s. Yes, they had choose your own adventure ones. Wait, am I supposed to follow that? Oh, that was a railroad track I was following. No, I don't want to go that way. I'm going to go out this way. That was a railroad track I was following. Where I went home early. I remember choose your own adventure. I did those ones too. Like you start to fall off the bridge. A gust of wind pushes you and you start to fall off the wind. Turn to page 18 if you want to reach for the ladder. Turn to page 21 if you flap your hands like a bird and try to fly. Stuff like that. Those were fun. And those were tricky for getting kids to read, too. Because, they're... Hey! Hellsmith! Hey, you read the Goosebumps? Yeah, the Choose Your Own Adventure ones was a tricky way to get kids reading. Because, you would read a little bit, and then sometimes you would end up reading the same paragraph a couple, three times because you choose the same, you know, the same scenario would happen. And you could finish the book a lot quicker because you didn't have to read the whole thing, right? You just read your choice through line and then you're done with it. Hellsmith, I'm glad you joined. Welcome. I know it's a little unusual today. I'm doing a Sunday or Tuesday instead of Sunday. I was a little busy on Sunday. I went down and ate at the Cheesecake Factory. Was not happy with that choice. A little overpriced for relatively mediocre food. Yeah, I was saying that the Goosebump books, I would always get so hooked at just like staring at them. They're so cool. I wanted to get all the books just for the covers. Except that had really good, don't judge a book by its cover, but oh, you can't help it with Goosebumps. A little overpriced, I know. God, that Cheesecake Factory was outrageously priced. And it's not worth it. Don't go to the Cheesecake Factory, people. I'd rather go, like, to the Olive Garden, to be honest. I feel like the Cheesecake Factory is like on par with Olive Garden, and Olive Garden is, I think, is more reasonably priced. Not that I love the Olive Garden, but I mean it's okay. Okay. So where? Oh, I wasn't looking. Oh, okay. I am getting closer, because now I'm at 0.11 miles. So I think it's going to be around here somewhere. I really do. Wait, is this 0.11 miles? No, it's going to be over here. I bet you it's over here in this mess. That's 0.9. Where's point 11? Point 11 is like over here. So let me follow this road and see if the time gets less or more. My throat feels kind of raspy too, like I'm losing my voice. I still have a little bit of like a leftover cough from when I was sick a couple weeks ago. I'm already here? I feel like that's what's going on. I feel like I have a little annoying nagging cough that's left over that I just kind of like, I feel like I always have a scratch in my throat. So this last week was actually pretty busy, besides going to the Cheesecake Factory. last week I forget what day it was. It was Monday. It was last Monday. I had, my coworker has season tickets to our local symphony, and he wasn't able to go to the show on Monday. So he asked if I wanted the tickets. I said, well, yeah, sure. And so we went and watched it. I went and watched the symphony. That was really exciting. He has like these seats that are way up high, and you're basically directly above where the symphony performs. So I like the whole time I was like leaned up against the rails watching them perform. It was really cool. We watched it was a piano concerto. So they rolled out the giant grand piano, and we got to watch from the top as the lady Kern is her name. I don't know the rest of her name. It just was Kern. As she played. It was nice. It was pretty cool. Wait a minute. Am I going the wrong way? How did I get through that mud? Wait, I was on this road? Oh, I followed this weirdness. I didn't stay to the right. Well, I'm going to go around. Because I'm not going through that. So it was Kern plays Grieg. And she gave an encore at the end of her performance. We gave her a standing ovation. She started to walk off stage. She stopped. She turned around. She came back and she played Flight of the Bumblebee. That was pretty cool. That was fun. I don't know how much it would cost for to be a season ticket holder to the symphony. I imagine it's pretty pricey, but it would be fun. It would be fun to be able to go to those types of shows more often. It was nice. I got all suited up. Not suited up. I got dressed nicely. I opened up the closet and took out my old suit jacket and put that on over a button-up shirt. I don't know if you can call that suited up, but I definitely, you know, got looking a little bit nicer than usual. Okay, and this is it. We're close because we're 0.02. I'm just gonna keep following the road though, until it shows that I'm going farther away. There we go. Here we go. Come on. Oh, we're going. It's farther now. Ooh, excuse me. Is it in here? Is it in this tree mess? Oh, come on. Where is it? I bet you it's up here. I bet you it's like right around here somewhere. Ugh. The beeping is, I'm supposed to be doing the triangulation. So, right there. Let's do it. Now I got one more and it's 0.64 miles away. So I bet you it is, how far is that? 0.3 miles away. How far is this? 0.6. So I bet you it's around here somewhere. I bet you it's in this mess up here. So let's get ourselves up there. Excuse me. Okay. How are we gonna get up there? Back up this road. This way. Yes. Let's follow this road and see what happens. Okay. All right. Sometimes you just gotta pick a route and just go for it. Oh, and I'm already at like half a tank. Where is that trailer store? Right here, the trailer store. So I should actually probably try to get myself to the trailer store, which I'm basically already almost there when I get there. So let's go this way. There we go. Oh my God, you know what else I've been watching? I discovered on Freevee, they have the Maniac Cop trilogy. I had seen Maniac Cop before. I mean, first of all, it's got Bruce Campbell, so of course I watched it. And I remember liking it. It wasn't great, but I remember thinking it was okay. And I just recently discovered there's a trilogy. There's three of them. So I went on to Freevee, and I typed it in, and I discovered it was on Freevee. So I was like, yes. So I watched the first one. It's still okay. I like it. And I watched the second one. The second one's better than the first one. The second one is like action packed and there's lots of stunts. Like people got hurt on that movie is what I was trying to say. People definitely got hurt. People were like falling from buildings, hanging on the cars as they're flying down the road. Like it was nuts. I was really impressed with, you know, the choreography and everything in that movie and the action sequences for, you know, an 80s horror movie. I recommend them. So Maniac Cop, the first two. I got through the first two. I still have one more to watch. Yeah, in the first one, Bruce Campbell plays this cop who this maniac cop is trying to frame him for murdering, you know, a bunch of innocent people. Well, in the second one, this maniac cop starts to like befriend a bunch of criminals and he gets like a little army and they start to like take over the whole city and these giant set pieces with, you know, action sequences and explosions, and I was like legit entertained watching that movie. All right. Oh, I gave a test. I'm giving a test. I wrote a test. I spent a lot of today and yesterday writing a test for my Math 1 kids, and I give it out tomorrow. So that's another reason why I figured I would stream today. It was because the day before a test is there's not much going on. I don't give out any homework. It's all study. It's all review material. I don't do any new notes because, it's all review. So the day before the test for teachers is like the slowest, least busy day. And then after tomorrow, I'm going to be busy all over again. I'll be grading. So I figured this is like the last little sliver of time I'll have to come on here and hang out before I'll be busy. I'll be busy with my red pen. There's actually a big like philosophy behind using a red pen to grade. A lot of teachers don't do it. A lot of teachers say that the negative, the red is too alarming of a color, and it creates too much trauma and stress around when kids review their work. And I don't know how I feel about that. I just think it's a color that's easily seen. You know, if I have a comment, red is spooky. Okay, so you agree. Red is a little spooky. I just think it's an easy color to see. So when I'm grading it, it's easy for me to kind of go through and see all of my edits. Also, I grade... either, oops, I'm going to hit the stump. Ooh, I knew it. You can grade negatively or positively. I do a summative grade. So I add points. I do additive. So if you got something right, I'll give you a plus one, right? If you got something kind of right, I'll give you a, you know, plus 0.5. If you at least tried and maybe you got a step right, but you got the rest of it wrong, I'll give you like a 0.25, right? I'll find something to give you a little plus four. So I don't do minus. So I guess that might help. That might, if I was doing all negatives, maybe I can buy into it. Yeah, if you see a paper full of red, then it's kind of discouraging. Okay, what am I doing here? Oh yeah, that's right. I want to get gas. So anyway, the point is, I'll be using a lot of red pen over the next few days. Okay, trailer store. I want to connect a fuel. Fuel, there it is. I can't buy it? Why not? Do I not have enough money? Am I broke? Or is it because I have this stupid thing? How do I see how much money I have? I have 73,000. Oh, you can't use that. I'm gonna run out of fuel. How close am I to this thing? I'm 0.25 miles. 0.2, what's 0.25 miles away? That is, I bet you it's up here. I bet you it's up here. I bet you if I leave here and turn this way, and then turn this way, and then go here, and then go here, follow this, and then go left out here. Oh my gosh, this is a long way. We'll double check here. So 0.25 miles puts me right here. I bet you it's up here, is what I'm trying to say. Because that's 0.25 miles. So let's get on our way there and see if that's consistent. Because there's nothing I can get here. There's no fuel, right? Is this a fuel carrier? That's this. Oh, I can attach to that. I can get fuel from that. Okay, I'm not as worried anymore. Okay. Refuel. There we go. Okay. There. I feel better. Oh. Got that grass, that tickle in my throat. I'm telling you. It's not becoming sick. It's being done with being sick. It's that lingering cough that I just kind of keep trying to cough to get it out, and then it just gives me a little bit of a sore throat. Oh my gosh, there's an out-of-body experience again. Ooh, come on, get up this hill. Get up this hill. Get up this hill! You guys, there's some video games coming out soon. There is a giant list of video games. I was on, I got on my Xbox a few days ago, and I was just looking at, like, upcoming games, and I went down a rabbit hole, guys. There's a bunch of games coming out. First of all, there's Division 3. That really hasn't been, that wasn't on Xbox, but that's just something that I definitely have been keeping an eye on. So, Division 3 is coming out within, I would say, within a couple years. So, I'm pumped about that. I don't know anything about it. I don't know what city it's going to take place in. I can hope. I can hope that it takes place in San Francisco, but probably not. It's probably going to be like Chicago or something. Or maybe it'll be in, like, it won't be in America. Maybe it'll be France. Paris. Or Montreal. Right, where Ubisoft is. Ubisoft lives there. I think San Francisco would be pretty cool. San Francisco would be pretty cool. But I don't know. So there's a Division 3. Speaking of Tom Clancy games, there's X-Defiant, which was announced a long time ago. And I played, like, what are they called? Not the demo, but the beta for it. And I liked it. I'm not the biggest fan of those first-person shooter multiplayer games, because I'm just no good at them. But I would play X-Defiant. I would play that. Oh, there's another Ubisoft game coming out. The Prince of Persia. That side-scrolling one. Frontiers. No. I have a list of games right here, and I read the wrong one. The Lost Crown. Prince of Persia, The Lost Crown. That looks good. It's a side scroller, and it looks like a good platformer. Almost kind of like, you know what it reminded me of? Metroid. Metroid Prime. Was it called Metroid Prime? No, Metroid. What was the most recent Metroid called? Okay, how far am I from it now? It says I'm 0.21 miles, and how far is this? That's 0.11, so it's not there. It's not there, but it's a little bit closer. I was here, and it said 0.25. Dread! Metroid Dread. Yeah, this new Castlevania... why am I saying getting all these games mixed up? I'm thinking of a Metroidvania, like Castlevania. This new Prince of Persia reminds me of Metroid Dread because of the fact that it's a side-scroller, and you're, like, jumping all over the place and trying to, like, you know, platform and you know, kill monsters. It looks good. Okay. So now I'm 0.21 miles. So I don't think it's up here anymore. Because that's 0.10 miles. So 0.21 is that over here? I keep pushing the wrong button. 0.21 is over here. We're getting closer. Yeah, I bet you it's around here somewhere. Because from here it was 2.5. No, actually it's probably, I bet you it's over here. I bet you it's there. I bet you it's behind me. Let's turn around and see if the increases or decreases. I also want to change the time. So this new Prince of Persia looks good. I'm pumped for it. Although the trailer is weird. You guys, they got the wrong music for it. Ubisoft has got this really big push to try to be, like, young and hip and modern. And that doesn't gel well with a Prince of Persia game. You know, the Prince of Persia was supposed to be like this really, you know, now I'm 0.25. I'm going farther away from it. So maybe it is over that way. It is behind me. It is over here somewhere, I bet. I bet you it's up here. 0.25, that's 0.7. I bet you it's right here somewhere. Okay, let's go there. Yeah, it's there. Okay. Anyway, Prince of Persia is supposed to be like, you know, a timepiece, old, almost like a romantic style era game. And like they had like this hip hop music. It just didn't look well. It did not look well for a Prince of Persia game. So that part kind of bummed me out, but whatever. The game looks, I'll play it. I'll play it and I'll enjoy it. Oh, that's where I wanted to take my left. Right there. What else I got on my list here? There's RoboCop, Rogue City. That's already been, that's available for pre-orders. You know, I have a pretty, I'm pretty, stern. about not pre-ordering games. I've kind of been let down too often when I pre-order games. But I'm telling you, I'm tempted to pre-order that RoboCop. It looks so good. It looks so good. I love that Peter Weller came back and is doing the voice. I love that they gave him like his old shiny suit back. It looks good. Yes, Super Mario Wonder is on my list. That one looks good too. I'm looking forward to that. I love Mario. Okay, where am I supposed to turn? Back there? I am. I overshot it. So I'm 0.11 miles. How far is that? That's 0.7, so it's not quite there. Not quite there. Oh, darn it. I'm going to keep going straight and see if it decreases or increases. Yeah, Mario Wonder looks good. speaking of Mario, Mario RPG looks good. I played Mario RPG for the Super Nintendo. I beat that. So I'm pumped about playing it again. Remastered. It looks good. It's not even remastered. It's completely remade. So we're at 0.111. 0.111. 0.11. Is it gonna go? It's going down. It went down, so I think we're on the right track. Oh, look, a truck. Huh. Okay, now it's going back up. Now it's going back up. So it's over here somewhere. It's over here somewhere. 0.12. And that's 0.11. I bet you it's in that little area right there. So we're gonna back up. We got to back up and we got to go out this road here. What is this mission? Whatever. Okay. Mario Wonder, Mario RPG, yeah, I'm excited about Mario RPG also. That one looks like a lot of fun. I think I can go this way. I'm not going to do it. I'm going to follow the road. What else do I have on my list here? Let's see here. Division 3, X Defiant. Oh, Sonic! Sonic Superstars! Oh my god, that looks good too. There might be a few side-scrolling games I'm looking forward to. The Mario Wonder. The Sonic Superstars and the Prince of Persia. Those are all three side scrollers. I'm looking forward to all three of them. I actually don't know much about the Sonic Superstars. I've only seen a few like not even full trailers, just like a few like clips of the gameplay, and it looks really good to me. Oh, look, we're already almost here. That's what it's about when you're looking for games, is I overshot it. You want, it's down here. It's down in this ditch. You want gameplay footage. Even, like, 10 or 15 seconds of gameplay footage is so much better than, like, a full, like, cinematic trailer. I hate cinematic trailers. They don't give you anything about the game. Point 0.6, 0.5, 0.4. We're on the right track. 0.4, 0.3, 0.2. Just keep going, big boy. Come on now. Come on now. There we are. Let's do it. I'm pushing the wrong button. What? I was just there. I'm gonna call Captain Planet on you. Ha! Indigo to Green is back. There we go. With our powers combined, this is Captain Planet. I remember that show. And I've been promoted. Woo! Okay. Now I think I'm ready for the mission. Okay, let's see. It's here, and it wants to be right there. Key building restorations. So I need to deliver concrete slabs and fuel. Where? So I need to deliver that to Zimnogorsk. Oh, we did the concrete slabs last week, y'all. Oh, that was rough. Remember that? We ended up going on overtime. And fuel. So I need to deliver fuel and the concrete slabs. So, okay. Yannick joined. Yannick, can you hear me? Yannick, if you can hear me, I'm streaming live on YouTube. Get yourself onto YouTube. Too bad about Kenny. And you can join me there and hopefully we can chat back and forth. Okay. How do I make him hear me though? I don't even know if he can hear me. I don't even know if this is worth it. This ain't worth it. Whatever. Okay. So what am I doing? I'm gonna recover. I need to deliver fuel and concrete slabs. And those concrete slabs are a pain in the butt. I wonder if it's easier to get concrete slabs from somewhere else. Okay, customize my truck. And I want to change the frame add-ons to this. Okay. How do I... Oh, he's here. Okay, so leave garage. Can I text a message? What am I doing? I don't know what I'm doing here. Whatever. He's gonna be driving around doing what he wants. So I want to activate this mission. I wonder if he can see what I activate. So I want, what did I want? Oh, it's up here. And it's called Key Building Restorations. Accept. And there it is. That's what I want. So concrete slabs are down there. That is a bit out of the way on this map. It's a little more... I'm not going to go that. I'm going to get him from the quarry. Do you think there is a trailer at the other gas station? Do you think there's a trailer there? So let me go to the quarry. Let me go to the global map. The quarry. No, I'm at the quarry. Zimnogorsk. Do you think there is this little... Where did that gas station go that was up here? Wasn't there a gas station up here? Wait a minute. Where am I? Am I at the quarry? I'm at Drownlands. Here's the quarry. Okay, so this little area up here, do you think there is a trailer that I can use? Because that's where I want to get the fuel. Oh, this is going to be tough, y'alls. Okay, hold on. I'm thinking. I want to be here. Yes. And I want to be in a... Key building restorations. Fuel. Why isn't it letting me view it? Whatever. Upgrade. He upgraded it. He discovered an upgrade for me. Look at him driving around. Yeah, you go, boy. Help me out. Okay, anyway. What the heck am I doing? Oh, there's the upgrade right there. I see it. I see you. Okay. So I don't know what to do, guys. I'm just gonna get a trailer. Hopefully I can make it. Just a regular trailer, please. No, back up. Just a regular trailer. Just a regular, everyday, regular trailer. Why do they look like... Okay, that one looks perfect. Okay, let's go. So I want concrete slabs. Two concrete slabs. That's going to take this whole thing. That's going to take all this trailer. And fuel. You know what I should do? I should get the big trailer. The big one. You know the one. Can I carry that in this? We're about to find out. Okay, so let's get rid of this trailer. Let's sell it. Sell. There it is. Okay. Now, I'm going to attach that big trailer. Hopefully I can. You guys, I'm worried this is going to end in a disaster. I should just take two trips. Okay. Ugh, okay. Not enough space. How can I get space for that? Ugh, okay. Ugh, okay. A little bit forward. You guys, this is a mess. Okay. Okay. I don't know if this is gonna work, guys. I'm worried. I'm already worried about this mission. Okay. Let's bring this big old honky trailer, two concrete slabs, and two concrete slabs and one fuel. Oh my gosh. Okay, I am going to activate, recover, change. I'm going to try something, guys. I'm going to try this real quick. I'm going to go to, let me change this real quick because, oops, wrong. Okay, I'm going to try this. I'm going to go to Steam. There I am. And I'm going to see if I can't friends. Can I send a message through Steam to somebody that's not on my friends list? Because I'm going to try to find the Cyanic character here. Find a group. Your groups. This is... Okay, add a friend. Let's try to find a friend. Oh, I have to have their friend code. Okay, friends. Okay, so let's search him by name. Okay, where is his name? Okay. Yannick Thaynden. Whatever. You guys, this is ridiculous. This is ridiculous. This game, I tell you, this game needs a lot of work, guys. As much as I like it, and I do, I'm in the wrong one. This game needs a lot of work. I don't know why I just can't talk to somebody in the game that I'm playing with them. Why do I? Oh my God. No, it doesn't have a chat. It's ridiculous. You have to either be on Discord or try to find him through, what's that called? What is it called? Steam. And in order to add through Steam, you need to have their friend code. I just looked over at my game list. I made a list of games that I was excited for because it really is a lot of games. Avatar, Frontiers of Pandora. You guys, that looks legit. And I don't know much about it. I just saw, like, the graphics look really good. It's like a giant open world fantasy game. I really hope it's good because, why not? Right? Why not have more good games out there? That's another one I don't know much about because most of the footage is like, cinematic. It's definitely first person, which I think would be better as third person. Be kind of fun to watch yourself run around as an avatar. How cool it would have been to communicate with players over the game. I know, over the CB radio. Oh, you're right. To have like a little sound effect over the sound of your voice to make it sound like you're on CB. Oh my god. Hellsmith. That's brilliant. That would be a lot of fun. And then you can upgrade your CB radio so you can talk to them like farther away on the map. That is a missed opportunity. This game, like, I don't know if this is even an indie game, but sometimes it feels like it is because it's just so, like, bare bones. The graphics are nice. The physics are nice. The gameplay is nice. It's just like the UI is really messy and convoluted. Even the controls are not quite intuitive. I get frustrated a lot in this game. So this game, it needs a lot of work. It needs a lot of work. And definitely in-game chat is needed because, first of all, not everybody has Discord. And to be honest with you, when this game was made, I don't think Discord was a thing. I don't think Discord was even a thing back then. So, like, you can't just depend on Discord to take care of all your conversations in-game. Maybe Discord was a thing. I don't know how long Discord's been around. Where am I going? Okay, I'm going the right way. Oh. Okay, it's 7:03. Am I going to be able to do this mission? I better be able to do this mission within the hour, guys. Because I don't want this one to be a long one all over again. Hitting. I think this is gay. This is my stream number 17. I have three more streams after this. I don't know if I can get this done in 20. I think it's going to take more than 20 streams to get this game done. I just think 20 is a nice number to finish on, but it might take to like 23 or so to get this game complete, because I'm pretty much done with this map. I just basically want to get the garage unlocked here, and then take the Taiga and my tank back to Alaska and get those maps taken care of. So I am just about done. And I think my next game is going to be the original Division. It's not written in stone, so it's not indefinite, but I'm definitely thinking about it. It's been a while since I played the original Division. I miss it. The new Division is, I like it. I have over 1,000 hours in it, but, there's a lot I miss about the original Division. All right, let's do it. Here we go. Okay, the quarry. This is going to be tough, guys. I need to get gas from here and two slabs of concrete, and each slab of concrete takes up two spots. So I have two spots available in my truck and then four spots available in this trailer. So the trailer is going to be all concrete slabs, basically. Okay. So it's really going to weigh me down. I hope I can get in and out of this place. So is this where this is where there's a fuel station. There's a fuel station right up here. So this is where I want to get the fuel. Wait a minute. You guys, I kind of just... What's going on here? Drown lands. Whatever. Thank you. Thank you, Yannick! Okay. What's going on here? Is he gonna let me do it or what? Am I supposed to go here? Did I go the wrong way? What am I doing? That red thing looked promising. I thought I was supposed to go that way. Okay. Yes, fuel. And how many do I need? Just one fuel. I'm bringing two just in case. And then I'm going to want to go here to get gas. Okay, then I'm going to have to do this all. I did this last week, guys, and it was really tough for me. So down here, it's going to be even harder with a double trailer. So down. And this switchback might be tough with the big trailer, but I'm going to try it on the way down. So come over here, get concrete slabs, okay? But then I'm going to have to go back up this way. Yeah, it's going to be tough. This is going to be tough, guys. Let's see what we can do. I wish I could talk to Yannick. I'd like to get some help on this mission. You know, maybe he can carry one concrete slab and I can carry another one or something like that. Ugh, and I just keep bottoming out over nothing. Yannick left the game. Well, it was nice of him to help a little bit. He helped more than I would help somebody else. I mean, not knowing what they're doing, you can't talk to him. Come on. Come on, let's get over there. Let's get through it. Row your boat. Come on. Just go, truck. Just go. Okay. You can do it! Alright, this is going to be a hard turnaround with this giant trailer. But we're going to do it. I'm definitely willing to take a chance with this trailer while it's empty, but I will not be doing this route when it's full of concrete slabs. Come on down. There you go. here we go. So I want concrete slabs in right there. That's where I want them. Okay, let's go. Oh, I'm all arching my back like, come on.
Get up there. Oh, you can do it.
All right, this is going to be hard to get this trailer up this spot right here. Don't tip over, just follow me. Don't tip over. Please? Please don't tip over? Oh, I don't think it's going to tip over, but it's going to be hard to get up. Come on. Come on. Yeah, you can see how heavy that thing is for trying to get up that weird... whatever that is. We're cliffside. This game is so relentless. Okay. 1 inch at a time! That's what they can call this game. Snow Runner, 1 inch at a time. Here we go. Remember the Sim games? Like Sim City? You'd be, you know, building your city all nice and pretty. Everything all in the right spot, right? You got your houses in the right spot. You got your, all your industry in the right spot. You got your, all your power plants in the right spot. You got the perfect number of power plants to power the perfect number of houses, right? Everything's all perfect. And then along comes an earthquake, messes everything up. That's what I'm worried about. Like, imagine if this game also had, like, natural disasters. An earthquake just suddenly, like, rattles you out of, off the road. Okay, so last time I went down this way, remember? And then when I was doing this part right here is where I got stuck. So I think now, this time, I want to go this way. I want to go this way and then out that way. Let's see what happens. I love SimCity for the Super Nintendo. That was my favorite SimCity. It was like just complicated enough to be fun and engaging, but not too complicated. The new ones are just too complicated. Like, there's too much to consider. I always get overwhelmed when I play the newer SimCities. Oh, my Friday the 13th video came out on last Friday. Friday the 13th, part 5, A New Beginning. That's what I watched for this year's Friday the 13th. I watched the Jason movie without Jason. And I got to tell you, it's so strange the way some videos get popular. You know, some videos I'm really, really proud of, and they just don't get very good traction. Other videos... I feel like I kind of slap them together and then they end up just, you know, going crazy. And this, all of my Friday the 13th videos, I'm very proud of all of them. The way my script and everything I do to put them together, I'm really proud of them. And, yeah, this one's not performing very well. I got some videos that are like, you know, thousands of views. They get hundreds of views a day. And, this one's like, you know, I'm at like 50. 50 views a week. It'll get there. It'll get there. I gotta remind myself that I'm doing this for me, you know? I gotta remind myself that this is just something that I enjoy doing, so. Friday the 13th, part 5, A New Beginning. If you haven't watched it yet, go give it a watch. Give it a like. I worked hard on it. Very proud of it. I gotta get through this mud. I gotta get through this water. Oh, here we go. that's true about TikTok. I started TikToking for a little bit. And it was amazing how many views some of my videos got. I don't TikTok anymore because I'm kind of over it. It is, it's too time consuming to put the videos together. It's too time consuming for someone like me who has a full-time job who just wants to relax. If this YouTube thing and all this, you know, social media was like my full-time job, absolutely I would. And it's not too hard. I can do it. It's just, you know, I don't want to. Yeah, you gotta like find that one part of your video that is, you know, a little more entertaining than the rest of your video, and kind of snip that bit out. Okay, here it is. Here it is. Guys, I think we're done. I think we's done. Okay, is this my right? Yes, it is. Now, where do I deliver it, though? Is it here? There we go. Woo! Look at that garage. Garage discovered. Okay, now, here's the kicker. Is there a trailer store that I can sell this trailer at? Is that a trailer store up there? Yes, it is. I'm gonna sell this trailer. Okay. Where's the sale? Did I pass it? There it is. Oh, it's the first one. Okay. You guys! Let me recover. But where am I? Leave garage. Am I in Zemnogorsk? Yes. I did it, guys. I got the trailer unlocked. So let me, I want to, recover this again. Yes, recover. And then I want to, put it in the truck storage. No, wait, what am I doing? Truck storage. No, I don't want to, wait a minute. How do I put this into truck storage? Retain. Okay, now I want to find my TUZ right there. Oh, what is this? It's an abandoned car, whatever. Okay. I want to recover this. Recover. And then leave. Now let's look. Are there any? Nothing. There's nothing. Nothing. Okay, so recover, and then store. And then I want to go to global map. I want to go back to Drowned Lands. And then this, yeah, he discovered a couple of upgrades. He discovered that upgrade. I want to get that upgrade real quick. That one and that one. Let's get those. So I want to... global map. No. Drowned Lands. Find the garage. This is what I'm talking about, the UI. Look how ugly this is. Go there. Okay. Truck storage. Yes. Get this guy out. Leave. And I want to collect this out here. And I want to collect this back here. Let's do it. Then I'm going to take this bad boy to Alaska. And that's our final stretch, guys. Alaska is going to be our final stretch. Ooh, look at that bounce. Look at that bounce. If this fence is falling apart before I even get to it. Okay. Show truck list. The Dawn. Thanks. Thanks, Dawn. Okay, let's get the one behind here now. Fences just explode. Okay, what's the best way to get there? This road over here. What time is it? 7:20? We may even have time to at least go to Alaska with these vehicles and kind of fart around. Get ready for next week. Next week, Alaska is on. Oh, yeah. Brother. Yeah. All right. What is this truck list? Yeah. Okay. Thanks, Russia. Okay. Let's recover. Store. And then I want to make sure there's no other vehicles out here. No, there's not. Okay, good. Let's go to global map. Alaska. This map that really pissed me off multiple times. And go to the garage here. Yes. Oh, that's right. I got to wait to move because this is the live game. Here we go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Okay. I definitely want this out. And I want this out. But I'm going to want to upgrade this though. So let's customize this. The engine is fine. Okay, the gearbox is fine. Off-road is on. Okay, suspension. Raise suspension, yes. Because I want chain tires. Yes, please. Wait, what's wrong? Why can't I do chained? I have to reach level 14. Oh, I'm level 13. I'm really close. Okay, well, hopefully I get to level 13. Winch. We're going to go with high power. We're going to spend 15,000 for a high power. Yes. Thank you. No. Snorkel? No. Frame add-ons? We don't need to worry about that. Okay. Now let's go back this way and let me customize this bad boy. Can I customize this? Explore the region to find it. Okay. Tires. Winch. Frame add-ons. Roof rack. Okay. Well, let's leave the garage. And what is there to do here? What was I doing here? Oh! This off-road. This rockstacle. I remember doing that. We're trying to. Oh man, this is going to be a pain in the butt. This is the hardest map. This is the hardest map. What time is it? 7:25. Let me. So rock obstacle was right here. Okay. And I got to, let me start tracking. Because I gotta get the metal beams from over here. So let me see if I can get there with this guy that I'm driving right now. So if I go up this way and over across this mud. Okay. And then across this way, then this way. This is, oh my God, this is a hard map. Look how far I have to go. So all the way over here to get the metal beams. Okay. And then I can't trailer it, but hopefully I can. Let's go. Come on. Hopefully I can winch it. Hopefully winching it will help me. Can I trailer? I can't trailer anything. But if this lets me drag it with a winch and then still use it, oh yeah. Or even if I can't drag it with a winch, even if I can just get it there and just drive there with my Tega and just attach it at that point, that would be helpful. Oh my God, I'm still slippy slidey though. I still need chain tires here. But at least this tank can move. Winandar, are you happy? There's snow? It's SnowRunner. Careful of the black ice. I know, right? I know. Winandar is thrilled. This thing does go pretty slow, but I'm okay with that. As long as it doesn't stop moving. Hey, Sly Rye, welcome. It's good to see you. Yeah, back to Alaska. So we finished Tamir. We got this thing, this tank, and we unlocked the garage in Zimnogorsk. So I'm coming back. We're going to do this with my upgraded Hega and this guy. I feel like I'm finally able to compete with Alaska Wilderness. So Sly, you weren't here a little bit ago. We were talking about, this thing is a beast. I love driving this thing. It's so satisfying. When I started this stream, I started talking about Goosebumps. Did you read any of the Goosebumps books? I was talking about how I remember reading, like, you know, Say Cheese and Die. There was the Monster House one. Oh, there was the green goo? Uh-oh, I think I froze. There it goes. The green goo stuff? I remember, what was that called? Something about the basement. Don't go in the basement. And then it had like a bunch of green goo that was coming down the stairs. I like that one. I honestly mostly remember the book covers over the actual plot. The plots were all basically the same. The plots were all basically, I hate my older sister, she's so annoying, and, oh my God, my older sister saved me, now we're friends. Or, you know, I hate my older brother, like it's just like, it's always about siblings who hate each other, and then something happens, and then now they're friends. Yes, the Scholastic Book Fair! Oh, we get like a magazine. Did you get a magazine in yours? You get like a magazine, and you'd pencil in the books that you wanted, and then you'd like mail away a check, and then you'd wait for like 4 weeks, which was forever when you're a kid, and then you'd finally get your books mailed to you. Oh my God, I did. I ordered a few books. I think I got like, I don't know if I got a Goosebumps books or not, but I definitely got, what the heck was that called? Like Ripley's Believe It or Not. I remember I bought those books. And like Guinness Book of World Records. For some reason, I always liked that stuff when I was a kid. Oh, the Scholastic Book Fair. I remember those. I did. I got a few books from there. What's the equivalent of that now? We don't have that. I don't know, because I don't teach elementary school, because that was an elementary school thing. But in high school, we definitely don't have stuff like that in high school. We have a library. I guess the kids can go to the library and get a book, but nobody's doing that. I have like a handful of readers in all of my classes. Like three or four kids who are consistently reading a book. Yeah, it was fun, and you'd forget until they showed up. I remember the Scarecrow book cover for Goosebumps, but that's about it. Yeah, I remember the covers mostly too. I don't really remember the plots. Okay, what am I doing? You know what? What am I? Oh, you guys. Okay, here's what we're gonna have to do. This is going to be a two-man job that I'm gonna have to do as a one-man person. So I think the biggest thing for me to get through is going to be back here. So this spot right here, this is going to be the hardest spot to get through. Because I remember I got all the way there on my own with the Tega, but coming back was tough. So if I park this thing in the middle of all that and then use this as like a winching point for my Tega, I think I can get through it. I think I can get through it. So Sly, did you have your trivia night? Any trivia that you can grace us with? I'm trying to think of trivia that I came across this last couple of weeks. One tonight, but yeah, I didn't. Oh, you didn't go. There was a trivia night tonight. I haven't gotten a trivia night yet. I think about you always. Whenever I'm out and about and I hear about a trivia night, I always think, oh, Sly Rye. Trivia night. You're like inspiring me to try it. So I'm going to put this thing right here. Okay, I'm going to put it right there. And then I'm going to go back to the garage. Come on, where's the garage? There you are. And then get my Tega out. There you are. Now, I have to get to level 14 before I can use chain tires. But I think having the raised and off-road tires should be better for this. But where am I going? I do want to go out this way. And then I want to... Yes, I want to follow this out this way. This is where I take my left. And then I'm going to use that thing to get me through there. Yes. And then I can get out here. And then get whatever I need. Metal beams. I should bring it. I should get a trailer. I should get a big trailer also, and then also bring metal beams straight down, because I think I need metal beams for other things too. This thing's already driving better with these tires that I have on here right now. Because before I had like regular road tires and it wasn't raised. So this is already better. So when I finally get to level 14, I'm level 13 right now. By the way, how do you see when you level up? Oh, are you pushing the wrong button? Where is my progress? Oh, whatever. That's something else that they can work on in this game for UI. This game's far from perfect, okay? Am I right? This game is far from perfect. That really shows you, like, like how good this game really is, like how much it has to offer, because I mean, with how much, with how bad the UI is, it, this game is, it really shouldn't be interesting to play for anybody. But the fact that the, I mean, the graphics look nice, the physics are really good, the leveling system is really good. So I mean, this game has a lot to offer besides, you know, oh crap. Oh good, I'm getting through this. Yeah, so I mean, this game's good is what I'm getting at. It's good even though it sucks. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. Yeah, this isn't as bad. Here we go, we're moving. We are doing it. Okay, I heard one of the trivia questions from tonight was, what year did these happen? Iron Man 3 released, Frozen released, Spurs lost NBA championship to Miami Heat. What year did these... Oh, all those three things happened all in the same year? Oh my gosh, Iron Man 3. That's... I don't know about Frozen, though. 2000... When was Let It Go so popular? Let It Go, Let It Go. When was that popular? When was that going? I'm going to say 2000. Is it 2017? Anybody else have any guesses? You guys, I can't believe I was worried about that. This whole time, I was worried about getting my Tega through that. Like how easy that was. Oh my god. Sly Ride 2017. That's my final answer. Does anybody else have an idea? So Iron Man 3, Frozen, and the Spurs lost NBA championship to Miami Heat. Or, yeah. That's my guess. 2017. Me 13? Are you kidding me? Oh my god! 2013. I thought that was more recent. For some reason, that Let It Go song is so like fresh in my memory. I knew Iron Man 3, I knew was like older, but for some reason, Let It Go in my brain was like so recent in my head. Oh crap. That is crazy. 2013. Okay. What else happened in 2013? I want to get this and I want to fill it up with metal beams. Okay. Metal beams. All right, I want metal beams everywhere. I want metal beams coming out of my butt. I want metal beams everywhere. Okay. 2013. What else happened in 2013? Let me think. 2013. What was I doing in 2013? I don't remember. I don't remember that far back. 10 years ago. I guess that does make sense, though, because Frozen, like, has its own musical, like, on ice. I know they have Frozen on Ice. So, it does make sense that it's older because of how popular it is now as far as, like, being retro. So, okay, yeah. 2013, that makes sense. I should have known better. 2017. 2017 is probably when the newest Frozen came out. Who can Google other big movies that came out in 2013? What other big movies came out in 2013? When did The Dark Knight come out? With the Joker, with Heath Ledger as the Joker. When did that come out? 2007? No, later than that. 2000. I think Batman Begins came out like in 2007 or so. 2008. Wait, 2008. 2008 was when Batman Begins comes out, right? Look how easy this is, guys. I can't believe I hesitated to do that the very first week I was out here. Oh my god. Batman Begins was 2005? Oh my god, The Dark Knight was 2008. Oh wow. You guys, I don't know this stuff. Anything after the 2000s, I have no idea. I feel like I'm pretty good with the 90s. I feel like if you give me an average movie in the 90s, I can usually tell you about when it came out. But after the 2000s, I clearly have no idea. 2008? Okay, whatever. Where am I going? How much farther is this? Yes, I'm almost at Robsticles. So I want to take a right here. Wait, where? That's fine, yeah. Batman Begins was 2005. Batman, The Dark Knight Rise, Dark Knight was 2008, and The Dark Knight Rises was probably then 2010 or 12. Yeah, Rises with 2012, okay. That movie gets a bad rap. I think it was a drop-off after Dark Knight. But, I mean, it wasn't terrible. It was pretty bad. There's a lot going on. There's too much going on in that movie. Oh, this is pretty windy. And the snow... All that black ice isn't helping. Okay. Let's bring this down. Here we go. Okay. Metal beams. Yes. Okay. So, something else wants metal beams too. What else wants metal beams? Is it this one? No. Is it this one? Yes, this wants metal beams. So, where is that? Oh, I'm not... Oh, nope. Okay. I still need to go from here, though. I need to get the metal beams from here still. Yeah, it's better to go that way. Does this need metal beams? What is this? Metal bridge. I bet you that needs metal beams. Metal bridge. Let's just drive to that. I bet you that needs metal beams. Where am I? Okay, so follow this. Just keep going. Keep going. We're going to get ourselves to that metal bridge. I bet you it needs metal beams. It should need metal beams. Doesn't that make sense that the metal bridge would need metal beams? Okay, I'm going to bring these there. Hopefully they need metal beams. If they do, then we're done. If they don't, then we're done. Okay. What year was this? Dumb and Dumber, The Mask, Ace Ventura. 1990. Those all came out in the same year? Are you sure? The Mask, Ace Ventura. Those all came out in the same year? Those didn't all come out in the same year, did they? I'll tell you the order they came out. Ace Ventura came out first. Then... Wow, that's crazy. Three movies in 1 year. They came out... Ace Ventura... Then The Mask... And then Dumb and Dumber in that order. And I bet you... I'm going to say 1994. Ow. Yes, yes, yes. I didn't know they all came out in the same year. Yeah, Ace Ventura came out first. That's how I got introduced into Jim Carrey. I love that movie. That was a good one. I also like The Mask. And when it first came out, I did not like Dumb and Dumber. It wasn't silly enough for me. Because he had just come off of those two like giant cartoon characters. So he did Dumb and Dumber and it wasn't silly enough for me. But now as an adult, I love it. I think it's a great movie. And same thing with what was the other one he did? That was a little more serious but still kind of funny. Liar Liar. When that first came out, I did not like it. It wasn't funny enough. It wasn't silly enough, I mean. But yeah, looking back on it, that's one of my favorites. I love Liar Liar. I also liked Ace Ventura 2. I like that one. Sequels aren't always, you know, good. But I liked Ace Ventura 2, When Nature Calls. That was a good one. Ooh, jackknifing over here. You know what? Dumb and Dumber, The Mask, Ace Ventura. I bet you any one of those movies could have set Jim Carrey for life. Let's see here. Show task. Accept. Start tracking. Metal beams. Wait, why isn't it? Drop it off. Where do I drop it off? I have to drop them off on the other side? Are you kidding me? Oh, this game sometimes. How am I going to get over there? Can I just throw them? Are you serious, game? God, this game. Okay, you guys, I'm gonna try. Can I drive it, you think? It's like this game, it's like twisting the knife. It's just like, I want to be that much more annoying to you. Oh, this game right now. It wants me to drop it off on this side. Ugh. How the hell am I gonna get there? I can't get there. Oh my God, this game. What the heck is this game thinking? Can I drive through this mess? Well, you guys, that's going to be a mess that I'm going to take care of next week. Because I don't... Is this game serious? It wants me to only drop them off on this side. Every other bridge mission, I can drop it off on either side. But this one, it wants me to drop it off on the side that's farther. The side that you can't get to, basically. Alaska is not only the hardest map, it's the dumbest map. This is a dumb map. Anyway. Well, we're done. Let me go here to, return to main menu. Yes. And let's see my stats. Let's see what my stats are. Okay. Let's go here so you can see my stats. Oops. This one. Okay. Trucks obtained 0. Missions complete 5. That's a good number right there. Upgrades and add-ons. That's 2. Those are the 2 that I got in Russia. Distance traveled 13.8 miles. Total cargo delivered 4 parts or 4. I don't know. Parts. That's weird. And damage received 244. Oh, any movies this Halloween? I don't know what I'm watching this Halloween. Definitely some horror movies. I love me some horror movies. We also had a Friday the 13th. So I watched Friday the 13th part 5. And I also put a review for it up on my YouTube. So if you haven't watched that yet, go watch my review for Friday the 13th part 5. Halloween. Which, I'm probably going to watch a Halloween movie, but which one? You know which one I haven't seen in a long time? I haven't watched Halloween 2 in a long time. Because I've been so caught up with that damn Gordon Green... what do you call it? Trilogy that he made. So he made Halloween 2018, which was a continuation from Halloween 1, the first Halloween. So he eliminated number 2 from canon. And then he made Halloween Kills and then Halloween Ends. So I've been really wrapped up with that for a long time. That I kind of I must admit, you know, I kind of left Halloween 2 out for a while. I kept it out of my mind. I was trying to devote my attention to this new trilogy that they were, you know, they were making. So I wasn't, you know, I turned my back on number 2 is what I'm trying to say. And I feel really guilty about that. So maybe I want to watch number 2. I'm going to watch Halloween 2. Sly Rye, you made my mind. Thanks for bringing that up. That's what I'm going to do. Yeah, 2 is a great one, Hellsmith. I love number 2. And like I said, when they made 2018 and they said that number 2 wasn't canon, I really bought into that. And I really tried to, you know, see it from that perspective. But, you know, looking back on it, the new trilogy they just made is like one really good movie. 2018 was a phenomenal entry in the franchise. And then Kills and Ends were like, they got worse and worse. And I'm not happy with the end product. But with Halloween 1 and 2, I am happy with the end product. I love Halloween 1 and 2 as a one story kind of a movie. They're great. They're really, really good. So yeah, Halloween 2. That's what I'm watching. All right, everybody. Have a good week. I'll see you next week. I would like to do Sunday again. I kind of like doing the Sunday thing, but I was busy last Sunday, so I had to, you know, postpone it to today. So hopefully we can keep it up with Sundays. All right. Have a good week, everybody.